There are millions of dollars out there on the market and thousands of people, maybe hundreds of people that are selling the same thing that you sell. So if you do a small calculation, you could understand that we can all be millionaires in the same market. Future millionaires, my name is Andreas Bolan and welcome back to my channel. In the last video, we discussed about if 2020 is a good year to start, and a lot of you told me that they understood the fact that we should all start businesses in 2020. If you haven't seen this video yet, watch this video here because I'll leave a link down below into the description. Well, today we are going to continue this video about how can we start a business in 2020 in order to make money, have success, and obviously get to the financial freedom. And most importantly, what I am going to tell you now, excuse me, is going to be money free. You will not need a lot of cash to do the things that I'm telling you here. With this being said, let's jump into the video. The first thing that you should do whenever you want to start a business is to look at the market. Do some research. See what the market needs. See that the people consume. How often do they consume? Who is selling what you are selling? See how the market grows, how the market flows, and discover what you can do best in order to be better than your competitors and to deliver accordingly to the needs of the people. How you can do that? Well, it's very simple. We live in a digital world and you must use your online resources in order to succeed. Well, you have Facebook, you have Instagram, you have Google, you have LinkedIn, you have everything that you need in order to see what people are using. You can join Facebook groups that are selling or consuming whatever you are selling. Let's say for an example that you want to sell baby stuff. Well, going to a group of mothers on Facebook that discuss about their babies and their needs. If you want to sell books, for an example, go into a literature group and see what people need, what people want to buy, and how willing are they to pay in order to get your products. Besides that, don't be afraid to ask people that are experts in that field to see what they have to say about the market, the specific product, the people that you are selling to, and all these kind of things. One thing that you can do, and this is tricky but is very smart, is to become a fake client. Put yourself in the position of a client for a company that delivers the same thing that you deliver. Let's say that you are a restaurant owner. You want to have a restaurant. Go to the places that are selling the same products and the same things that your restaurant will sell. If you want to create a pasta restaurant, go into the local pasta restaurants and see what they are doing good, what they are doing bad. Go to their Facebook page and see what people have to say about this. See how they are promoting themselves. See who are their suppliers and try to be better than them. Beat the competition with pricing and better deliverables. The second thing that you should do is to learn about what you are selling. Learn about the functionalities of your product or services. Learn why people need this thing. And this is very important. Understand the reasons behind the usage of the product. Learn everything that you can do about what you are selling. Learn about entrepreneurship in general. Learn how to sell, but most importantly, learn about your products because you need to be versatile in your products. You need to know how to adapt them. And if you don't understand why people are using it, if you don't understand why are they priced like that on the market, you will never understand why is your product working. And you might fail because you have a winning product, but you did not know how to sell it and who to sell it to. It costs you literally $0 to learn about the market because you have the free digital world, and it costs you zero money to learn about your product. It is that simple. You don't need money to choose what you are selling and who are you selling to. The next thing might sound very harsh for the lone wolves out here, but you need to find the right partners for many reasons. One of them could be they might know more than you know about the specific niche, the specific product, or the specific market that you are trying to sell into. Well, this might be in your advantage because they have the knowledge, you have the desire and the passion. Maybe you are better at entrepreneurship than them, and you can all combine this information in order to succeed on the market. This puts you 1,000 steps ahead of your competition if you begin with the right partners. Another reason for why you should start with a partner is because you can split the initial investment. It's better to have 50% from something than to have 100% of nothing. Yes, it's very important to find someone that has at least the same amount of money as you have in order to start the business. Because if you have the money, you can scale faster and faster and faster. You have money for your employees, you have money for your market, you have money to test things out there on the market. And this is very important. This will give you a very, very, very big leverage on the market. And the third reason for why you should have a partner is because they have a separate network. Yes, they have a network, they have potential clients, potential people that can help you with the business, and it's very important for you to have direct access to that people. For example, my partner brought me some clients in the company from his family. Yes, his family was some of our first clients, but at the beginning when the business needs cash flow, that 2-3 people are very important for small businesses, including you as an owner of that business. What is the first thing that you think you should do with your partner? Stop the video right now and leave a comment down below on what you think you should do and tell me if you guessed it. 3, 2, 1. Your time is up. So, the first thing that you should do when you start a business is to create a plan. Do a business plan, because as I said in the previous videos, if you don't have a plan, you do not have a business. You should take care of your numbers and your action plan. See what you are going to do, who are you going to deliver, how you are going to market that product, and most importantly, do a financial plan, because you might notice that the market is way bigger than you first supposed. Yes, the market is bigger. I could say that the market is infinite because you have a lot of potential clients. And hear me out, there are millions of dollars out there on the market and thousands of people, maybe hundreds of people that are selling the same thing that you sell. So if you do a small calculation, you could understand that we can all be millionaires in the same market. Even if it's local, even if it's global, we can all make tons of money out of that market. I encourage you, if you have a passion and you know some things about this, I encourage you to create a digital marketing agency the same as I have, because I think there is enough place for everybody on the market. The first thing that you should include in the business plan is the MVP. What MVP means is minimum viable product, which means you take a short period of time where you test on a small market if your product is going to sell. If you sell baby diapers, for example, you should talk with the mothers, explain to them why your product is good, sell them on some platforms like Amazon or local platforms if you are not from America, and see if your product is going to sell or are going to sell if you have many products. Well, you need to do the minimum viable product. Ask people for their opinions, but take care and take that into consideration. Make sure that these people that you are asking and people that you are trying to approach are in your target zone. If they are not in your target zone, which is another thing that you should include in your business plan, you might get confused and you won't understand why you are not selling, and you will think that it's because of the product, when the product should be a problem and could be a problem, but most importantly, make sure that you are selling the right product to the right people. So make the minimum viable product. And now that you already tested your products, you had the MVP, you had the plan, you had the partners, you had the whole things done, what you should do is to go on social media. Promote yourself, start your marketing campaigns offline and online, but make sure that people know about your product. Now that you bleed ambition and success out of you, it is the perfect moment to start selling on a larger scale. Make sure that you have already said, and if you have already said, it's time for you to go out there online and sell it and make some real money. Now you might think, Andreas, In the title you said that we don't need money to do this and now you are telling me to market myself on the internet, which means paid. Well, is this video a clickbait? Well, no, because going on social media, it doesn't mean necessarily investing money. You can promote yourself organically. There are a lot of communities, a lot of Facebook groups, a lot of Instagram pages willing to help you in order to succeed. How you can do that? Work with influencers and with people that are actually liking your product and see what barters can you make with them in order for them to help you to promote yourself. Create content, learn how to create content or find a friend that know how to create content and see how they can help you in order to grow organically. Your first sales, your first 100 sales could be without investing zero penny. Now that you have 100 sales, you have what is called cash flow. And cash flow is the most fundamental thing in a business at the beginning and at every certain point. And we'll have another video about cash flow exclusively. Once you have cash flow, you have money to invest. You have money to pay your suppliers. You have money to market yourself. You have money to bring some people in your team that can help you grow faster and faster and faster and to grow that snowball in order to have success. Hope you get me right. Now we know what we should do in order to succeed, but there are some specific things that you should look at in order not to fail. Take care of the next few topics. And the first thing that you should do is to take care who are you asking for advice, because there are a lot of gurus that have nothing to do with the business or the specific thing that you are trying to sell, the specific product or service, and they will give you inputs and that inputs are not valid because they are not in your target. They are not in your target, they are not business wise, they are not business gurus in your niche, and you should take care of that advices, but until a certain point. See if what they are saying is valid to the market, and if it's not, don't take that advice into consideration. It's good and I highly recommend you to ask for opinions, but make sure they are valid opinions. And since we are talking about people, and this is very funny for me, make sure that your haters are non-legit. You have haters, that's true, but make sure that haters are non-legit. Let's give an example. Let's say that your mother doesn't support you and she doesn't believe in your product. If your mother is a teacher, she might not be in your target if you are selling, I don't know, car wheels. If you don't sell something that is deliverable for the specific people, if that people hate you, it's okay because they are not in your target zone. Yes, you should listen to what people have to say, but make sure they know what they are talking about. The internet is full of haters and all the content creators have haters. I do have haters and I had them all the way, but I try to ignore them and now I succeed to ignore them because I know they are not legit. They are lower than me on a social scale. They don't know what they are doing with their lives. Some of them are druggy and I'm not afraid to say that, because this is the reality. You will have haters from people that should not be important for you. If a person is better than you and the person knows what you are doing and is doing it already, trust me, that won't be hate. They will not hate you. They will give you inputs and they will be more kind and they will be friendly with you. That person should be taken into consideration. However, if you have one person or two person or 10 persons that are telling you that no bro, you can't succeed with this, maybe you should still not take that into consideration. However, if you have 100 persons that are telling you that no bro, this is not good, and this is the MVP phase, what I was talking before, yes, if 100% of people tells you that you are drunk, you go to sleep. And this is a moment where you can realize that your product is not going to sell, but make sure you target the right audience when you're talking about product selling. Another thing that you should do is to take care of your money. I talked about this before, but I'm telling you now, if you have money to invest, if you reach the cash flow, it is very important to see how are you going to spend and divide the budget in order to succeed, because the budget needs to be there. The business need the money. Grant Cardone has a saying and he says, feed the beast, feed the beast. What does that mean? Well, it's very simple. He says that all the money that you can do in the first month of years of the business should be reinvested 99% in the business, because the business is the beast and it needs to be fed. If you don't feed the beast, probably is less likely to succeed. You need to put the money where they belong, which is in the business. See how much money are you going to invest in the marketing. See how much money are you going to save. See how much money are you going to pay for the stocks that you are doing. Invest wisely. Invest all the time, but invest wisely. And here, let's talk about numbers. What I do is that 10% of everything that I earn from my revenue is going to saving account. I save them for bad days. I don't know when I'm going to use it, but it's a budget that is been growing. I think in the last 7 months, I haven't touched that budget. So this is what you should do. Another part of my money, and I think 20% of it in average, are going in my personal bank account. Why is that? Well, that is because I have a very good cash flow in all of my agency. My profit margins are over 60 or 70%, and 20% of this 100% of revenue are going into my pockets, because I have a strongly belief that you should pay yourself first. If I make a sale, I get a commission. Even if it's my company, yes, you heard me well. Even if it's my company, 20% of what I do is going to my personal account, and well, what I do with that money is my problem. But 20% of that money are going to myself, because I know that I worked for that thing, and this is my work, not company's work. Another part of the money, and I think this can be more than 10%, should be in the taxes. Make sure that you have to pay taxes, and you have to pay them in time. Take care of that and put a budget, because if you don't have money to pay your suppliers, you might have a problem. But if you don't have money to pay your taxes, you'll have serious troubles. And hear me out, guys, because I had this problem in the past. Make sure that you put the money for the taxes. And this is what you can do with all the budgeting. And we'll have another video about how can you do the budget right in order to make a lot of money. And the last on the list, but not the least, is pay attention to the competitors. The market is full. Every market has a lot of competitors. What you should do is to look at them, make sure what they are doing, make sure what they bring new on the market, and try to be better than them. Okay, they already have a fan base. They already have some clients. There is no problem in it. But look at them. Analyze them. Don't be afraid to knock on their doors and ask for things. As I said, be a fake client to see how they are operating. And if you understand how they are operating, it's very easy to see what can you do better. If they create content, see what cameras are they using, see the equipment that they are using, see who are they delivering to, see what are their prices, and try to beat them at every chapter. Because if you do that, in a few months, trust me, you will be better than them. People will recognize you, and you'll have a big part of the market in your pockets, because the outcome will be that you will make money. This was the video, guys. Thank you for watching. If you liked it, don't forget to subscribe to my channel, press the notification button to see when I come up with the next videos, leave a like, and don't forget to share this video to other people if you think that my information is good and actually can help someone to achieve their goals. Thank you, and until the next time, I hope this period is finding you well. See you.